الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله من بعد. Brothers and sisters, the topic of Dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a very important topic, one of the main topics in Islam. Because you enter Islam by Dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by saying La ilaha illallah, you are a Muslim. This is the best dhikr, as it came in the hadith. The best dhikr is La ilaha illallah. And you end your life with La ilaha illallah. You enter paradise. Dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are in any difficulty, make dhikrullah. Allah saved Yunus. Yunus is one of the prophets, alayhi salatu wasalam. When he was inside the stomach of the whale, لولا أنه كان من المسبحين للبث في بطنه إلى يوم يبعثون. If he was not one of the مسبحين, he was making dhikr. Not only, يعني the scholars they say, not he was making dhikr only inside the stomach of the whale. Also before that, he was a person of dhikr. Allah saved him. Allah saved Yunus because of tasbih. فنادى في الظلمات أن لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. He invoked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said في الظلمات. The scholar said three types of darkness. The darkness of night, the darkness of the sea, the darkness of the whale, stomach of the whale. Logically, this is impossible for him to live. Impossible. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him because of dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah said, sometimes, يعني, you know, when I come across a mas'ala, like an issue, يعني, you know, sometimes it is not easy, the issues of knowledge. Nowadays, يعني, you know, there are big issues. Maybe in business transaction, this is halal, this is haram, this is allowed, this is not allowed. So they do conference to decide this is haram or halal. This is makruh or mustahab. صح? Okay, like we, for example, organ transplantation. This is one of the new issues, big issues in the Muslim ummah. The scholars discuss this. So Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah said, sometimes an issue comes to me, so I am struggling in this issue. I don't know, this is halal, this is haram. Then he said, I make istighfar, 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 until Allah gives me the solution. Dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So of course, يعني, this doesn't mean that I make, يعني, maybe when students say, okay, I'll make istighfar, I will not study. No, this is not like that. Shaykh Hussain Taymiyyah is a scholar. He studied the Quran, the Sunnah, but يعني, subhanallah, the understanding from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, so with, of course, with the studying the Quran and Sunnah, you need dhikrullah to help you. So brothers, sisters, you have any difficulty, or let's say before any difficulty, we should not wait the calamity to come. We need to be prepared, well prepared for any calamity, any difficulty, any war, any problem. Make dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not only dhikrullah, dhikrullah kathira. Much of dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you notice in Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned 10 criteria. 10 characteristics of the believers. Okay? 9 of them, okay, sa'im, mutasaddiq, qanit, okay, giving charity, inna al-muslimina wal-muslimat, al-mu'minina al-mu'minat, okay? Mutasaddiqina mutasaddiqat. With all of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not mention kathira. Those who fast, give charity, who pray, night prayer. But when he came, subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the end of this ayah, to mention, and they make dhikr, he said, وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ. So you should make dhikr a lot, طيب. What is the definition of dhikrullah kathira, Shaykh? Okay, what's mean dhikrullah kathira? It means subhanAllah, 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 24 hours? Of course, this, we don't mean 24 hours. Make dhikrullah. طيب. So one of the definition or the, يعني ابن الصلاح, one of the scholars of hadith, he said, if you say the dhikr now after salah, after every salah you say dhikr, fajr, dhuhr, asr, maghrib, isha, or also jum'ah, also after witr, you say dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala في الصباح والمساء, morning and afternoon, and you say dhikr for the sleeping or when you wake up, then you are one of those who are making dhikrullah kathira. Alhamdulillah, this is very easy. So dhikrullah kathira doesn't mean you make dhikr 6 hours, 7 hours. This means after the salah you make istighfar, tasbih. Wallahi brothers, it will take maybe 3 minutes or 4 minutes. The morning adhkar, the same thing, 3-4 minutes. When you wake up, alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana ilayhi nushur. When you go to bed, bismika allahumma amutu ahya. And if you like, you add. When you enter your house, bismillah. You leave your house, bismillah tawakkaltu ala Allah. You eat, bismillah. You finish, alhamdulillah alladhi at'amani hada. You are one of the dhakirin Allah kathiran wa dhakirat. Then you have a stamp, you are not a hypocrite. Alhamdulillah. Mabruk. You are not a hypocrite. Wallahi. Why? Because this is the difference. This is the difference, or one of the differences between the true believer and the hypocrite. The hypocrite, he has dhikr, but very little. Very little dhikr. When he's coming to the salah, very lazy, very late, or he's not coming to the masjid. But subhanAllah, the believer, no. He comes, he thinks always about the masjid, the salah, the jama'ah, and congregation. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as we mentioned, كان يذكر الله على جميع أحيانه. He likes to make dhikr all the time. All the time he likes to make dhikr in a state of wudu or not in a state of wudu. When he wakes up for the night prayer, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد وعلى كل شيء قدير, سبحان الله الحمد. He makes dhikr. Then he recites the last 10 آيات of Surah Ali Imran. إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات أولي الألباب. Well, yesterday, yani, something made me to feel very sorry. Okay, yani, one of the sisters, I say, yani, they have someone who is sick, so I say, make ruqya for them, for your daughter or for your friend. Make ruqya, you recite Surah Fatiha, Ayatul Kursi, you recite the last two ayat, آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربي والمؤمنون, قل هو الله أحد, قل أعوذ برب الفلق, قل أعوذ برب الناس. That's it. She said, wallah, sorry, Shaykh, I'm not memorizing Quran, this ayat. Astaghfirullah. Yani for, she's a teacher, yani for sure she is more than 25 or 30 years old in a Muslim country. She doesn't memorize Ayatul Kursi. Aman al-Rasulu. Subhanallah, wallah, I feel very bad for the Muslim ummah. Of course, not all of them. Not all of them. But yani, very simple. سورة الفاتحة قل هو الله أحد قل أعوذ برب الفلق قل أعوذ برب الناس آية الكرسي آمن الرسول. Okay, if we are not memorizing this ayat, so for many years what we are doing, brothers sisters? Only you are busy in our business. Be busy in the dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we mentioned the hadith مثل, what is the example? The life and the death. Those who make dhikr, they are alive. Those who don't make dhikr for Allah, they are dead. They make dhikr of dunya. What is the price of gold today? It went up, down. The bitcoins, the shares. Talk about the dunya. The wife, the car, the mobile. Traveling, business. Where is dhikrullah? Subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not in there. Notebook. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who make dhikrullah kathira. Jazakumullah khairan wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala Muhammad.